Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm doing very well. Thank you for asking. This is the show where I answer the questions that you ask me. What have you asked me this week? You've asked me a lot of questions about Evernote. You've brought something to my attention about Google Maps, and you've asked me about how I create my screencasts yet again. So we are going to cover all of that and a little bit more today on Ask Dotto Tech. I have to have a big shout out to Hugh Dinwiddie, who saw our video a couple of weeks ago where I was showing how you use Google Maps and a utility for measuring areas, things like the surface area of a roof, that sort of stuff. And he said that I was actually doing it the hard way. He discovered an easier way to use the built-in measurement tool in Google Maps. And I probably should have known this myself, but I didn't. Thank goodness Hugh decided to share it with us. Let me show you Hugh's technique, which seems to me to be a really good way to use Google Maps for measuring distances and areas. And let's just let's switch over to the Google Earth view of Google Maps, and let's find the location that you might be interested in doing a measurement on. So let's just go along here. This is a kind of a semi-industrial area along not too far from where I live, actually. And let's say that you were one of these, you know, in one of these properties here, and you were trying to figure out, maybe you were going to put a new parking lot, or you wanted a fence. Maybe you wanted a fence the length of this property right here. So you had to measure the distance. Now, you could go out and do it the old-fashioned way and measure the distance, but according to Hugh, if I right-click my mouse, now this only works on the desktop version, but if I right-click my mouse, I can say measure distance. If I go and right-click my mouse again over here, it measures the distance from one point to another. And look here, it gives it to us in both feet and inches, both official measurement. It's about 19 meters or 62 feet. Now, if I now want to make this an area measurement, say I was looking at maybe replacing all of the concrete from there to there and adding some to here. So now I'm going to add another point by going distance to here. I'm going to finish it off adding distance to here and then close off the loop. What it does then is it measures the total area and it gives me the actual surface area, which is 2,900 square feet or 270 square meters. Isn't that, that's easier than the way that I showed you. So I have to give a big shout out to Hugh for showing me a better way of doing things. That's one of the things I like about this show. People ask questions. I give you the best answer as far as I know. But then people watching the show sometimes have better solutions and they give us better answers. So sometimes we will be returning to questions with better solutions. Hugh, thanks so much for jumping in and filling me in on a better way to measure area and distances in Google Maps. Now, let's jump over to Larry's question. Larry's asking about Evernote. Says, love Evernote. Love my clear and simple explanations. Well, thank you very much, Larry. Question, is it an easy way to insert the date and time in a note? Automatically, even. I thought about a do button, but I don't really understand what I'm doing. Thanks, Steve. Well, in fact, there is a dead simple way of doing that. We are in Evernote here. That's where I'm reading your note, Larry. And if I just put my insertion point anywhere in the document, if I go under the Format menu in Evernote, I can insert the date and I can insert the time. Isn't that nice? A very quick and automatic way of inserting date and time in any note. It couldn't be simpler. Spend a little bit of time in Evernote, Larry. Poke around. Look at the different menu items. You will find all sorts of things you didn't know you could do. For example, you could turn this into a checklist just by putting your cursor in there and then turning on the checkbox. Now this becomes kind of a to-do list. You can do that from the toolbar. You can also do that from the format menu. So there's lots of different ways to add some extra formatting into Evernote and automatic processes for doing things like date and time. So thank you, Larry. Great question. Good answer, I think, and one thing I like about that answer is it was clear and simple. Let's stick around in Evernote for a few moments, and it is back to school time. It's just the beginning of September when we're recording this particular episode, and Brad Turner mentions that he's new to Evernote, but see Evernote as an exciting as you do some of your videos, but I wanted to set up a shared notebook. Here it is. Between myself and my son, who attends high school, he's entering grade 9 in September. Congratulations, Brad, son. I hope you enjoy grade 9. And he wants to basically set up a note for each of his classes that he can enter the homework and what day the particular class is on, some details, and share the notes with Dad so Dad can help and they can sync back and forth between the notes. And he's wondering if Evernote would be ideal for this. In fact, Evernote is completely ideal for this. Allow me to show you. So again, we're still in Evernote right here, Brad. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go over into my Evernote account and I'm going to go into the notebooks. This brings up all the different notebooks that I have available to me. And I'm going to create a new notebook because what we're going to do is we're going to take advantage of the sharing capabilities in Evernote. And we're going to actually create a shared notebook for you and your son that you can share your documents back and forth and you can both access whenever you need it. So we're going to call this Brad's notebook and or not your book, notebook. Let's just fix that up. There we go. Now, when I create that notebook, it's right here. We see it right here. I can go in by double-clicking on it. I open the notebook, and there's obviously no notes in it yet. I can add new notes to the notebook. You might be wanting to add a new note, different notes for every class that your son has taken. So we'll add science here, and we'll add another new notebook, and we'll add math. Go through all the subjects, because what I'm thinking about having is we might have a working document here where your son goes in and enters all of his different homework assignments. Hey, he can even use that automatic date feature to add the date, so you know what day it was when he had the assignment, and then he can add whatever assignments he has. Now, that's all fine that it's saved into a notebook, but here is the key. You go under the share menu, and there you choose to share the entire notebook. When you choose to share the notebook, a little dialog box will come up warning you that you're about to share it and then allowing you to enter the email address of said person who you wish to share it with. So if I wanted to share it with myself, with my demo account, I'd enter the email address and then I would tell it to share. Now, the magic thing that happens when you do that is you have the opportunity to do one of three things. You allow the person sharing the notebook to view the documents, to edit them, or to edit an invite. So what's the difference? Well, obviously view, they can just view them and they can't make any changes. Edit, you can make changes to any note within the notebook. Inviting means that you could bring a third person into the group. So for example, maybe there's a peer tutor that's working with your child and you want to give them access. You can give them access to individual notes or to the entire notebook this way as well. So this can become a collaborative tool for you all. The net result is if your son is being good about things and he is entering all of the different information that he needs to in the notebook, you will be able to view the same notebook up to date as fast as he's entering any information from your mobile device or from your computer. And whenever you make changes or add suggestions into the notebook, he will be able to see it from whatever device he's accessing Evernote on. This doesn't have to be from a computer. It can be from a tablet. It can be from a phone. It's nice and flexible. So I think your question of using this for supporting your child's homework is an awesome use of Evernote. So I have to thank you very much for that, Brad. Great question. Let's move on. And Jim, before we leave Evernote, Jim has one last question about Evernote. Now, he's looking at using the Evernote web clipper and the screenshot function, but he wants to be able to capture a screen area that's larger than, say, the website that he's looking at individually. So he's wondering about using the Evernote web clipper for capturing a larger area. Now, the Evernote web clipper indeed actually does do that. So let me just jump over back into the web browser and let's take a look at it. Here's a typical web page that you might want to be capturing. There's plenty of information, what we call below the fold, that you'd have to scroll down to. So if you were using a standard screen capture tool where you were marking the screen, you wouldn't be able to capture the whole screen. Now, you could do that a little bit by reducing the size of the window, but that's not really going to help you in all cases, and it's certainly not going to allow you to capture larger pages that scroll down quite a ways. But if we use the Evernote web clipper, and we've got plenty of videos here in the channel on how to use the Evernote web clipper, this is it right here in my toolbar of my browser. When I click on that, it launches the Evernote web clipper, and it gives me several different options to save an article, a simplified article, which strips out extraneous information. But this is the one we want. We want to save the full page because then it will clip the entire page that we're on. When we do that and click save, what'll happen is it will then sync it to our Evernote account. We'll give it just a second to do that. Let's jump back over. There it is. It's syncing right now. I can see that happening. So when we jump back over into Evernote, if I go into my notes here in Evernote, we should see the new document here. Just momentarily. There it is right there. So there's the web page that I just clipped. Now there's the information that we saw above the fold But as I scroll down, there's the rest of the page. So all of the extra information that we wanted to capture from that page has indeed been captured in this note. So using the Evernote web clipper, telling it to capture the full page is the way that you capture a screen area which is larger than the window of your computer. I hope that helps a lot. So let's see what we have. One other question. What's our other question? We've done the Google Maps. We've done the Evernote web clipper. Oh, William Wilkins asks again, how do you create a video with you in front of your computer screen? It's cool. I'd love to see a video on for my website. You know something? Here it is. I will teach you exactly how I create these videos. If you just go to dottotech.com, if you drop by our website right now, right here at the top of the page is Screencasting Secrets, how I create my videos. Click on that link. You will be sent to a page where you give me your email address, and I will send you a one-hour webinar where I teach you chapter and verse everything that I do in order to create my videos. What could be easier? And thanks so much for that question, William. There we go. That is all the time we have for this week's show. I want to remind you, if you do have questions, please post them right here in YouTube in the comments area. I will reply to everyone I can, and if it makes for a good video, I will include it in the Ask Dotto Tech videos here. And if you prefer, you can also go to our Facebook page, facebook.com/DottoTech, and there you can enter questions as well. I monitor both places for questions, and I'm happy to answer as many as I can here on Ask Dotto Tech. That is all the time we have for today. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle. Mm-hmm.